Okay, so let's start with some inchworms. Just big reach up, bend at the hips, and walk yourself out. Pull that high plank, and then walk yourself back in. Big reach up. Pull that plank. And back up. This time I want you to add in a pike. So hold in that high plank. And then from here, lift your hips up. And then bring your head in between your shoulders. Okay, come back to high plank and walk yourself back up. Let's do two more. Walk it out. Pike. Get a good stretch in your shoulders here. Back to high plank. And we're gonna do one more. High plank. And back. Good. Warms up the shoulders a little bit. Okay. And then we're going to do that long lunge. So take a step forward with your right leg. Okay. Now I want you to bring your hands on to the midline of your body right beside that right foot. If you can, drop that right elbow towards the right foot. Okay. You can let your right knee swing open a little bit. And then I want you to bring your right hand so that it's pointing towards the ceiling. Okay. Put that hand down and switch sides. So just opening the hips here. Again, drop that left elbow to that left foot. And rotate. Bring it back. Same thing on the other side. Okay, switch sides. Good, that'll be the last one we do. I want you to go into tabletop position. We're gonna do hip cars, just to warm up the hips a little bit more. So your hands are tucked underneath your shoulders, knees are underneath hips. You're gonna start with bending the knee at 90 degrees and keeping that 90 degree angle, okay? You're gonna extend as far as you can back. From here, you're going to open up the hip. So you're doing external rotation of the hip. So your knee will be coming outwards and your toe and your heel would be pointing inward. And then I want you to bring it around like a big circle with your knee and then bring it back to starting. Let's do that again. Extend back to start, okay? Externally rotate, so you're opening up your hip, okay? And you're doing a big circle with your knee and bringing it back down towards the floor. So that's three. Extend. Four, let's do one more. Extend. And five on the other side. The aim of this one is just opening up the hips a little bit more, trying to get some of that rotation there. One. Two. Extend, open, bring it around. And back to starting, that's three. Extend, open, bring it back to starting, that's four. Let's do one more here. And five, good. Bring it down. down to your back. We're gonna do some glute bridges. Okay, all the way down to your back. We're gonna go up. Hold for two and down. All the way. Up, hold for two. Down all the way. We're gonna do six of these. Three, squeeze at the top. Three, four, five, and six. Good. Okay, so we're gonna start with the warm up. We're gonna do it a little bit different this morning. So we're gonna do spot jogging for 15 seconds, and then basically I'm just gonna coach you guys through what I want you to do. Just basic exercises to warm up, but just a little bit of a different format than what we usually do, just to switch things up a bit. So just jogging on the spot for 15 seconds to start, okay? And then I'll explain what the next one is. So I'll time you here in 3, 2, 1, go. 15 seconds, just jogging on the spot. We're just warming things up here. So in 5 seconds, I want you to go down to your knees and push-ups for 30, okay? 3, 2, 1, down to the ground, bend your knees, push-ups for 30 seconds. Just warming up the chest. Get that chest right down to the ground and push yourself back up. 10 more seconds. In 5, you're gonna go into a plank hold. So 3, 2, 1, you're holding a plank, either from your elbows or from your hands, okay? So right into it, you guys can go ahead, 30 seconds. More seconds, keep going. Really bringing that belly button up towards the ceiling. 3, 2, 1, back up to standing on the or jog on spot for 15 seconds. After this 15 seconds, we're gonna do jumping jacks for 30. And then we're gonna go through that circuit again. 3, 2, 1, jumping jacks, 30 seconds. Ten more seconds, and then we're going back to jogging on the spot. Keep going. 3, 2, 1, jogging on the spot. If you want, you can pick up your knees a little bit higher just to increase your heart rate a little bit more. Okay, after these 15 seconds, we're doing back to push-ups from knees. All right, back down to the ground. Push-ups from knees. Down, all the way up. Fifteen more seconds, keep going. Five more seconds and you're moving to plank. 3, 2, 1, moving to plank. High plank or from your elbows, whichever you want, right into it though. Five more seconds. to your feet, jogging on the spot again. Just keep moving. 15 seconds. Again, we're gonna go into jumping jacks in 5, 3, 2, 1, jumping jacks, go. 30 seconds. Keep going, check the time. 10 seconds. We're gonna go back to jogging on the spot in 5, 3, 2, 1, jogging on the spot. Okay, this next one is gonna be so you guys keep jogging, I'm just gonna explain. Prisoner squat, so elbows are coming behind the head, down to a prisoner squat. Okay, that's our next one. Ready, and go, hands behind head, down to a bodyweight squat. We're doing 30 seconds of these. Keep going. So keep going with these. The next one we're doing is back flies. So after this, you're going right down to your stomach. 3, 2, 1, come down to your stomach, right onto the ground. Okay, feet are up, hands are out, and I want you to bring your hands, your pinkies together. Okay, keep your head off the ground, squeeze the shoulder blades together. We're going for 30 seconds of these. Right into it. So I'm touching my thumb down to the ground, bring my pinkies together, and at my mid-back point, okay? So my hands aren't way down here, they're not way up here, they're kind of in that middle part of my back. Squeezing the shoulder blades together. 5 more seconds, and then we're going to jogging again. 3, 2, 1, all the way up. Jog on squat, right back into it, 15 seconds. We're just constantly moving. For the first warm-up part here. Okay, 5 more seconds. We're going to jumping jacks for 30. 3, 2, 1, jumping jacks, go. Keep going, keep going. 10 more seconds. Three, two, jogging on spot. Last time with jogging on spot. 15 seconds. Pick up those knees if you can. Okay, ready? And prisoner squat. Hands behind head, right into a squat. 30 seconds. Trying to get your hips back. Okay, I know it's a little bit harder, especially when you have your hands behind your head. But still try and get those hips back when you're sitting in a chair. Weight's going through those heels. 5 seconds, and then we're going to back flies. Keep going. In 3, 2, 1, down to the ground. Back flies. Last one for warm up here. 30 seconds. Angle. Squeeze the shoulder blades together. You can straighten those arms out all the way, or if you want to slight bend in the elbows, that's fine too. 5 seconds. 3, 2, and 1. Awesome. Okay, grab some water. And we're gonna start with the workout. Okay, so I'm just gonna kind of explain because we haven't done this before. So I have 6 circuits for you guys. They're all supersets though. So there's just 2 exercises. And we're gonna work in like a hill formation. So you're gonna do, the first 2 are goblet squats and plank to stand, which I'll explain those. But basically we're gonna do them 5 times, but you're alternating each time you go. So the first one you're starting with is goblet squat for 30 seconds on, 10 seconds off. The next one you're doing is plank to stands for 35 seconds on, 15 seconds off, back to goblet squats for 40, 20, and then you're gonna work your way back down the hill, basically. Okay, so the first one's goblet squat. So if you have your weights, so you can use a kettlebell, you can use dumbbells, you don't have to use anything. But the first one we're going is 30 seconds on, 10 seconds off. So for the first one to start, 30 seconds is not a ton of time. So if you wanna go a little bit heavier and then get a little bit lighter as we go, that's something you could do. So 30 seconds, goblet squat. Okay, ready? This is our first superset. 3, 2, 1, and go. So weights at your chest, all the way down, all the way up. After we're done these 30 seconds, you get a quick 10 second break. And we're going into those plank to stands for 35 seconds. Okay. 5 more seconds. 3, 2, 1. So quick 10 second break. I'll just remind you of plank to stand. Hands go down, feet kick out, and back up. Okay, so that's our next one for 35. Ready and go. Plank to stand. Hands down, feet out, feet back up. And stand. So there's going to be a strength exercise followed by a cardio exercise for all 6 of these supersets. 35 seconds of these. Ten more seconds. Three, two, 1. Good. So now you have 15 seconds. Grab your weight again for your goblet squat. Now we're doing 40 seconds on and 20 seconds of rest. Okay, we'll get started. Ready? 3, 2, 1. 40 seconds. Go. All the way down, push the hips forward at the top. Keep going, I'm gonna check the time. 10 more seconds. 3, 2, and 1, awesome. So you got 20 seconds to rest. We're going back to the plank to stands for 35 seconds. So now we're working our way back down. Okay, get ready. 5 seconds, 3, 2, 1, and go. 35 seconds. So grab your weight again. Okay, we're doing 30 seconds in 3, 2, 1, Go, 30 seconds, last set of the first circuit. Try and lock out those knees at the top. I know I always say to squeeze the glutes, but remember to lock out those knees, squeeze the quads. So you're pushing those knees back, okay? Locking hips and knees out at the top. 5 seconds. 3, 2, and 1. Awesome. Okay, good. First superset done. Moving on to the second one. Grab some water if you need. And I'll explain the first one here. So the first one, similar way we're doing this, Superman holds, okay? So you're on your stomach. Arms are straight out beside you. You can be up at 45, they can be up here, okay? And you're holding this position for that whole duration. So 30 seconds, 40 seconds, and then 30 seconds again. And then our cardio exercise for this one is mountain climbers, okay? If you want, like, if you have smaller weights, like 5s or 8s or something, you can hold those up while you do these if you want to make them a little bit harder. If not, just stick to body weight. Okay, let's come down to our stomachs. Okay, so I'm going to start here in 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, 30 second hold. Do try and get those like quads off of the mat. Try and get your chest off the mat so that just the tops of your ribs are touching. Hands are completely up to the side. Straight elbows. Lock it out. Keep breathing, keep going. 5 more seconds. Hamstrings should be on, glutes should be on. 3, 2, and 1. Okay, 10 seconds. Quickly into mountain climbers. Okay, on your hands. 3, 2, 1, mountain climbers, go. 35 seconds. They don't have to be fast, they can be slow, but keep the butt down. Don't let the butt float up to the ceiling. Keep going, keep going. You got 10 more seconds. Push it, push it. 5, 3, 2, and 1. Awesome, okay. 15 seconds here. Now we're going to that Superman hold for 40 seconds. So 10 more than we did before. So get ready on your stomachs, on your mats. 3, 2, 1, and hold. Get that chest off as high as you can. Okay, all your glutes and your low back should be holding yourself up here. Hands out to the side. You guys got 10 more seconds. Try not to let those quads fall. Try and have the tops of your knees off the ground. You're pushing your hips in towards into the floor. 3, 2, 1. Awesome. Okay, you got 20 seconds here. So just get ready with your mountain climbers for 35. Okay, just take a couple breaths in here. Get ready in 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. 35 seconds, mountain climbers. Go. Try and get that knee right up to the chest. Okay, don't let your head hang so that you're looking at your knees, looking right at the spot, right underneath your eyes, so your neck stays nice and straight, your spine stays neutral. Drive those knees up. 5 more seconds, keep going, keep going. 3, 2, 1, awesome, okay. Last one here, Superman hold, 30 seconds. Great, ready? And go. Hold it. Chest up, chest up. Going, keep going. 3, 2, and 1. Awesome. All right, grab some water. Well done, well done. Okay. So while you guys are just grabbing water, the next two exercises following the same format, push-ups. Okay, just push-ups, regular push-ups from your toes, and then jack press. So if you have like a lighter dumbbell, okay, I'm doing basically like a jumping jack, but I'm pressing the dumbbell overhead as my feet kick out. Okay, those are two that we're going back and forth. You can do this with a kettlebell too. Okay, so push-ups to start with. For 30 seconds, you can start from your toes. If you need to drop down to your knees at any time, that's fine. Or even starting from your knees, all good too. Okay, so let's start with the push-ups in 5 seconds here. Getting ready in 3, 2, 1, push-ups, go. Drop that chest to the ground. Similar to those mountain climbers, don't let your head hang. Okay, try and keep it upright. You got 3, 2, 1. Great. Okay, grab your dumbbell, quick switch up to standing. Okay, jack press. Quick transition here, ready? 3, 2, 1, and go. 35 seconds. Drive that weight overhead as your feet kick up to the side of you. 10 seconds, keep going. Three, two, and one. Nice, good. Okay, back down to push-ups. This one's 40 seconds, so this is gonna be our longest one, our toughest one. Okay, get ready. Starting here in 3, 2, 1, and go. If you find that your form's struggling, drop down to your knees. Okay, tuck those elbows in, make sure they're not out to the side. You guys got 10 more seconds. Keep going. Push it through, push it through. 3, 2, and 1. Good. Grab that dumbbell again to jack press. Seconds. Ready, standing, and go. 35 seconds. Drive that weight up, kick those feet out, and bring everything back to the center. Keep going, keep going. 5 more seconds. 3, 2, 1. Okay, great. Back to push-ups. Last one with the push-ups. down, breathe out as you come up. Consistent breathing with this one. Push those palms of your hand through the floor. 3, 2, and 1. Nice. Okay, great. Grab some water. So we're 3 out of 6 done here. So we got 3 more to go. Okay, while you guys grab your water, this next one, we're gonna do a shoulder press. You're gonna start on your right knee, okay? So your kneeling position, your right knee's back, your left foot is forward, and you're gonna grab your dumbbell or your kettlebell on your right side, okay? So the first 30 seconds, we're just doing right shoulder press, okay? And then our next one's jump squats. And then when we get to 40 seconds, you're gonna grab a second dumbbell or plate or kettlebell and push them both overhead. Okay, last time through, we're gonna switch and do just on the left side. So just get ready with your first dumbbell or kettlebell. Okay, so right knee's back, left foot is forward, and you got the dumbbell in your right hand, okay? So shoulder press for 30 seconds. So if you can go a little bit heavier, if you have a little bit heavier weight, try it on this first one. Okay, ready? 3, 2, 1, and go. Up, just down so that it taps the shoulder, okay? Just taps and all the way back up. Just tap the shoulder all the way back up. When you press it up, try and get that bicep right next to the ear, okay? Locking out that elbow, bicep right next to the ear. Keep going. 3, 2, and 1. Good, standing. Jump squats, okay, here for 35 seconds. Ready? Go, 35 seconds jump squats. Nice soft landing. Try and bend your knees as you come into your landing, right? You don't wanna jar your knees. Try and go right into that soft landing and back up. The quad burner, keep going though. 15 seconds. If you need to drop to body, just body weight with no jump, feel free to do that, okay? 3, 2, and 1, good. Okay, grab that second dumbbell for this second one here. Doesn't matter which foot goes in front, whatever you feel most comfortable with. Okay, so we're in that kneeling position, we're doing both at the same time for 40 seconds this time. Ready? 3, 2, 1, and go. Push up, back down to shoulder height, together. Back down, push together. Still trying to get both those biceps right next to those ears. Breathe in as you bring them down, out as you bring them up. Doesn't have to be fast. Ten seconds, keep going. This one's hard. Keep pushing. 3, 2, 1, well done. Okay, come up to standing. You guys got 20 seconds here. So if you need to just shake out your legs or your arms before these jump squats, you guys have 10 more seconds. So just keep moving. All right, ready? 3, 2, 1. 35 seconds, jump squats, go. Modify as needed, okay? If you wanna do, you know, 3 body weight squats and then 1 jump squat, that's totally fine. 3 and then a jump squat, or just keep going with the jump squats. Modify. 5 seconds, push it right to the end. Last 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Awesome. Okay, 15 here. Now we're working that left shoulder. Right foot's going up. Okay, right foot flat in front of you. Left knee is on the ground. Weight's in your left hand. Okay? 3, 2, 1. And go. One arm shoulder press. Push, try and get it up there. Keep going, 30 seconds, almost there. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Well done. Okay, grab some water. We got 2 more of these supersets. All right, the next 2, no weights required. We're doing plank reach outs. So you guys have the option to do these from your elbows or from your hands, okay? So you're doing reach out, alternate, reach out. Okay, similar, just on your hands. Okay, the ones on your elbows will be a little bit tougher. And then we're gonna superset with high knees. Okay, so this one's all core cardio, this superset. So let's start on our plank, in our plank position, plank reach outs for 30 seconds, whichever position you want to be in. All right, let's get started here in 3, 2, 1, go. Plank reach outs, 30 seconds. Whether you're on your hands or your elbows, make sure they're right underneath your shoulders. Okay, especially the ones with your on your hands. You're gonna wanna tend to keep them a little bit in front of you, but I want your body right over top of those hands. Hold that core in, pull it in. 3, 2, 1. Okay, back up to standing again. Okay, we're doing high knees for 35 seconds. High as you can go. Ready, and go. High knees, drive them up, high as you can go. 35 seconds of these twice. Drive them, drive them. Then you're bringing your knees right up to your chest. Keep going. Three, two, one. Awesome. Back down to the ground. Plank reach outs. Okay, we got a 15 second here. Not much of a break. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Plank reach outs. Go. Seconds of these, and then we're making our way back down the hill. Keep breathing with this one. This is like a cardio exercise in itself. Keep going. Breathing, breathing. 3, 2, 1. There we go. 40 seconds is done. Let's move back to 35 seconds of high knees. Okay. Last time you're doing high knees. So really get them up there. 35 seconds. All right. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Go. High knees. Consistent breathing in through your nose, out through your mouth. Every time you feel like your knees drop in, try and get it back up there. You guys got 10 more seconds. Keep going. Breathe, breathe. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. There we go. Good. Okay. 15 seconds. Get your breath back down to plank reach outs for 30. Okay, get ready. 3, 2, 1. Plank reach outs. Go. 30 seconds. Okay, we're on to the last superset. So the next one is reverse lunge to a side or front raise. Okay, so I'll just demo here quickly. So you're going back into a reverse lunge, come up, side raise, okay, alternate. So you're not doing any arm lifts on the bottom of this exercise, you're doing it while you're standing. So reverse lunge, stand, raise, reverse lunge, stand, raise, alternating. Okay? So if you have lighter weights, you can use those ones for those side raises. Or if you want to do front raises too, you can do that as well. Okay? So 30 seconds. Let's start here in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, reverse lunge. Okay, stand up, side raise. Reverse lunge, alternating, remember, stand up, side raise. So you're holding those weights beside you. Here we go. Good. Stand, side raise. Yes, good. Keep going, 5 more seconds. 3, 2, and 1. Okay, good. Next one you're doing is toe taps. So you can put anything in front of you, like just using it basically as like your cue. You can put a dumbbell down. I'll use this pillow. Okay, basically what we're doing is just quick little toe taps. Okay, for 35 seconds. So like I said, you can use this dumbbell or you don't have to use anything. I just find it a little bit easier to use it for a cue. Okay, so for 35 seconds, just quick feet. Just those quick toe taps. Ready? And go. 35 seconds. So you're seated back, okay? And just your feet are moving forward. Quick toe taps. Tapping out in front. Ten more seconds. Keep going. Quick as you can. Quads might start to burn here. 3, 2, and 1. Whew, good. All right, reverse lunges, side raise, 40 seconds. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go. Reverse lunge, up, raise. Reverse lunge, up, side raise. Forty seconds. Keep going. Three, two, one. Good. Okay, those toe taps again. 35 seconds. So we're gonna start here in 5, three, two, one. 35 seconds, toe taps, go. Bring that core in. Okay, bring that belly button in. Hold the core tight while you're doing this one. Breathing, breathing. Move the feet fast as you can. 10 more seconds. Three, two, one. Awesome. Okay. Reverse lunge, side raise. Final one of our six supersets for 30 seconds. All right, get ready. We're gonna start here in three, two, one, and go. Reverse lunge, stand, raise. Reverse lunge, stand, raise. Keep going, check time. 5 seconds. Three, two, and one. Awesome. Okay, grab some water. And then I have a 4-minute core finisher for you guys. Okay, so you guys grab water, I'll explain. And then we can get right into it, do our cool down. So we're gonna do 4 minutes. There's 4 different core exercises. Oops. So each one of them is like unilateral. So you're gonna do 8 per side. So the first one is bicycles, then hip drops, Russian twists, mountain climbers. I'll count these all out while you go. But basically you're doing 4 minutes. Bicycles, for example, you're doing like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You're doing 8 per side, okay? The next one you're doing hip drops. So again, you're doing 8 per side. 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 16. Okay, you're gonna keep going through all 4 of the the core exercises until the 4-minute timer is up. Like I said though, I'll count everything out as you guys go, but just know that you're starting on your back with bicycles, 8 per side, so 16 total. And it's going to be a core burnout. Okay, let me start the 4 minutes here. So on your backs, bicycles, 8 per side. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Timer started. Go ahead. After you do those bicycles, you're doing hip drops, 8 of them. So that's one, like going, dropping those hips to the side, 8 per side. After those hip drops, you're doing Russian twists. Again, 8 per side. With or without a weight, keep those knees nice and still. Let your eyes follow your hands. After Russian twists, mountain climbers, so 8 per side. 8 times driving each knee up to your chest, okay? Once you hit the end of mountain climbers, you're starting right back up at the top with bicycles. 8 per side. Hip drops after bicycles. 8 per side. Russian twists after those hip drops. Keep pushing through. Okay, after those twists, mountain climbers, knees to chest. You guys are more than halfway there. After that, back up to the top. After mountain climbers, back up the top to bicycles. Core is working. Hip drops after bicycles. A minute and a half. See how many rounds you can get in. Keep going. After hip drops, Russian twists. After bicycles, hip drops. Russian twists. After Russian twists, mountain climbers. You guys got 1 more minute till you're cooled down. Keep going, 1 more minute. Mountain climbers, then bicycles, back up to the top. Keep going. Seconds. Almost there. Keep going. Almost there. 10. See how many you can finish. Keep going. Don't stop till you hear the alarm. There it is, and stop. Well done. Nice job, everyone. Your cores are on fire. All right, guys, definitely earned a cool down, so let's do that. Grab some water, and then keep standing. Keep standing. Bring your hands together in front and all the way up to the top. Okay, let's bring ourselves over to our right side. So just pulling that right arm over, stand up, and then over to the other side. Now pulling that left arm. See if you can get a good stretch on the left side of your body here. Okay, bring hands back up to the middle, bend at the waist. Okay, try and bring your hands, your fingertips, your hands right to the ground, let your head hang. Good hamstring stretch. Okay, good, stand it on up. Let's do a wider base here. I want you to take your left arm, bring it over to the left side, and then you can let your right arm kind of come down your right leg. And then again, good stretch over one side of your body, really stretching that left lat. Okay, stand up, let that left arm come down and right arm all the way over. Okay, let's inchworm all the way down. Okay, drop down to your knees. Let the tops of your feet come onto the floor. Okay, push your hands through the ground. Try not to let your head sink. And then try and bring those hips, like hip flexors, towards the ground. Get a good stretch in your core, especially after that burnout I just made you do. Lift the chin up. Okay, tuck the toes underneath. We're gonna go up into a pike, and I want you to bring your heels towards the ground. So good calf stretch. Then bring your head between your shoulders. Okay, same thing. Walk yourself up a little bit, drop the knees, let the tops of the feet hit the ground. push your hands through and push those hip flexors towards the ground. Okay, curl the toes underneath. Bring the hips up and then heels towards the ground. Good. Let's sit in 90-90. So let's have right knee facing out in front of you, left knee is going up to the side. Okay, so just check that your knees are at 90 degree angles and your hips with one another. Bring both your hands and bring them in front of that right knee and bring that chest towards that knee. Okay, you can come down to your elbows. So you should feel that good glute stretch on the right side here if you're bringing your chest over the right knee. And just hold it here, good stretch. Adjust your knee if you need to. Okay, come back up to seated. I want you to stay in this position, but I want you to take your hands, bring them over to the right side of your body. Okay, we're gonna stretch that left hip flexor, push that left hip flexor into that right knee. Okay, so you're pushing this left hip flexor into the front here. And you're gonna get a good quad stretch on that left side. Holding. Awesome. Okay, let's switch sides. Left knee, point in front, right knee up to the side. Okay, bring your hands on either side of that left knee. Come down your elbows, bring your chest towards your left knee. Holding it there. Okay, come back up to seated. Now rotate to the left side, put both your hands on that side and push that right hip flexor now into that left knee. Okay. And then the last one we're gonna end off with is child's pose. We'll take a couple deep breaths in this position and then we will end the workout. So knees can point outward, sitting on your heels, walk your hands out in front of you. As far as you can, try and sit back, butt towards heels, and then bring the forehead towards the floor. Take a couple deep breaths in and out here, in through your nose, out through your mouth. Okay, all the way up to the left side. And last one, all the way up to the right. All right, hands to the middle, walk yourself back up. Well done, everyone.